This is part two of Psychology Optional 2023 paper two. Hello everyone. This is part two of Psychology Optional 2023 paper two. Paper two, part one I have done and I'm doing the part two analysis. So I'll be starting with the section B part, that is 5A question. So let's start. Explain with suitable example the psychosocial consequences of prolonged deprivation. Now, what is prolonged deprivation? You should define this in your introduction part. Now, prolonged deprivation means that for a very larger time, you are facing that kind of deprivation. So what is the psychosocial consequence of this kind of deprivation? So here you can mention about all the emotional distress, and since it is asking you with respect to psycho, that means they are asking you the issue with respect to the psychological aspects. So here you can mention about the self-esteem and identity issue. You can also talk about how there is a issue of self-trust that arises, that whether the person is capable of getting out of this prolonged deprivation or not. Other than that, you can mention about traumatic disorders that might arise at time. Other than that, you can also talk about social isolation, because you also know that in order to be in a group, that is a social group, there is a status symbol that is present. So one issue could be your socialization. Other than that, you can talk about the process of self-isolation. You can also talk about mental agony. Fine. All these factors can be mentioned in the psychosocial consequences. Now, other than that, you can also talk about attachment disorders, because after some time you have this trust deficit issue. So attachment disorders are also there attached to it. Fine, you can mention all this in this part. Now let's move on to the next part. The next part says, what are the measures to achieve social integration? Social integration is that everyone is bonded, or you can say everyone are some kind of cohesiveness is there. That is social cohesiveness. So here you can talk about how you can achieve so. So this could be achieved through education and awareness. This could be achieved through legality and advocacy frameworks. You can also talk about social integration if there is mutual harmony, and this is how or mutual harmony is coming, how when there is respect for everyone's culture. You can mention about this. Other than that, you can also talk about promotion of social order. So you can mention about social order. You can mention about inclusivity. other than that, you can mention about mental health support programs. Why this is necessary, mental health support programs? Because this would bring more acceptance. Fine. So all this could be covered in this part of social integration. Now let's move on to the next question. The next question says, explain the role of mass media in fostering societal values. So they led to awareness generation campaigns. They also bring in a lot of solidarity. That could be written about. Fine. Other than that, you can talk about because of mass media, there could be increase in community engagement programs. So you can talk about community engagement programs. You can also talk about again emotional intelligence. Fine. Other than that, it could also, or mass media could also lead to increase in civic participation. So you can talk about the factor of civic participation. You can also talk about ecological parameters because they also increase the social bonding and gathering, because for a certain cause people you get united. So ecological values. Fine. Other than that, role of social media can also challenge the stereotypes. So by challenging the stereotypes, and prejudices. So if social media is able to challenge, so then societal values can be fostered. Multiple things can be written. Some I have pointed out so that you could think in that direction. Let's move on to the next one. The next one said, what psychological interventions can be planned to improve the performance of athletes? Now, when we are talking of when we are talking about athletes, we need to know, or we all know that they have very precision for a high amount of precision for time and goal. Why time and goal? Because athletes' time is something like they can miss out on their goal with seconds. So what or how psychological intervention can be planned to improve the performance of athletes? Here you can talk about goal setting. You can talk about extreme rigorous trainings, because mentally they need to be very hard. So extreme rigorous trainings. Other than that, you can also write about what these people need to know, or the stress management should be there. Goal setting, extreme rigorous training, stress management. You can talk about attention, all attention gathering practice. For example, the attention should be very focused. So yes, focusing attention. fine. Other than that, you can also talk about what coping with injuries, team dynamics, because they have to operate in teams. So, team dynamics. And communication. Stress management, focusing attention, team dynamics and communication. Then you can write about how they are able to, you know, cope with their injuries no matter how harsh it is. So coping with injuries, then biofeedback, what is required or what their body demands. Biofeedback is there, team dynamics and communication is there, stress management is there, focusing attention is there, injuries is there. Other than that, you can also training. I have mentioned about extreme rigorous trainings. Then you can talk about mental toughness. Yes, mental toughness. You can talk about yes, I think this much is enough. If you are able to write this much, this would be sufficient. Now let's move on to the next one. How does self-fulfilling prophecy work in case of traditional Indian women? Self-fulfilling prophecies. So what you need to hear is to know what are your self-fulfilling prophecies. That means self-fulfilling prophecies refers to what? So first you need to know that self-fulfilling prophecies refers to what? It is a kind of belief or expectation that kind of generates in the person. So this belief or expectation, the question is asking you that the belief or the person's behavior or what are those expectations that, you know, the woman of traditional Indian or the traditional Indian woman holds with them. So here you have to describe and write about all of them. So first you need to know what are the self-fulfilling prophecies, that is their own beliefs and perceptions and expectations. So since they are asking you about traditional Indian women, so what you can talk about here is that they are, you know, socialized in a very, or their socialization how their socialization and upbringing is happening. For example, they are always taught to prioritize family first and not the career. So prioritizing family. You can also write about the prophecies regarding how marriage and family dynamics are shaped in the mind of the traditional woman. If you want, you can also give the historic practices, and you can talk about the sati practices or sati pratha etc. If you want, you can just give this. Then in traditional Indian women, the divorce case, or it is still considered a taboo. Fine. Other than that, you can also talk about internalizations of the belief. That means nowadays it is being said that they choose the household practices, and they should feel very proud, or there should be a feeling of pride in that. So that depends upon person to person whether they whether whatever they are prioritizing. So, but in case of traditional Indian women, it is household being prioritized. And when it is being prioritized, there is immense pride that is being held. Fine. Now let's move on to the next one. The next one says that discuss the steps to be taken to reduce the incidences of school dropouts among the deprived groups. Now the deprived groups, see, if you want, you can just write about national education policy also that they are targeting for 100% gross enrollment ratio. Now when they are targeting for that, that means you have to check the incidences of school dropouts and how is this going to happen. So for that, let's discuss the steps. You can talk about, see, firstly, the counseling part acts as a very important feature. So you can write about this with respect to the current affairs examples. For example, so many women candidates have cleared the examination, and you can give also the relevance of past so many years, even this just the year before, like all the top three ranks were taken by the woman candidates. So you can write about the counseling sessions. You can write about the early intervention session. You can have this build up of mental support system. Other than this, what could be done? You can also write about, just now I have told you about the women candidates who have excelled in this exam. So you can give the example of those. So other than that, you can also about role models. You can, ask for civic participation. You can also talk about community engagements. Fine. Okay, so counseling, early intervention, mentor support system, role models, civic participation, community engagements. You can also talk about, even teachers training, fostering an environment where they themselves want to enter this field. So fostering. Fostering an environment which is very self-progressive oriented. You can also talk about career psychologist. Those, etc. Fine. Discuss psychological strategies for handling intergroup conflicts. That means you need to talk about the strategies that would ultimately help in order to address the intergroup conflicts. So let's begin. Here you can talk about what? See, awareness acts as a very important part. Why? Because of awareness, what is going to happen? You can educate the crowd, and at the same time, biasness can be resolved. Then you can also talk about that the process of mediation. Mediation, conflict resolution, All this is going to resolve what? Your intergroup conflicts. Conflict resolution, mediation, awareness, biasness, resolveness, education, etc. Other than that, you can also talk about what, if there is any intergroup conflict, the factor of empathy, compassion for one another would help in resolving the conflict, because that will generate the feeling of humanity. So this is why intergroup conflict can be resolved. Fine. Okay. The next question is, what is achievement motivation? Discuss how family and achievement motivation, how discuss how family and cultural factors contribute to enhance achievement motivation. So achievement motivation is what? That means it act as a boost factor so as to perform better. So this motivation acts as a key factor that boost your boost your confidence and motivates you to perform better. Now they are saying how family and cultural factors help in or contribute to enhancing motivation. So you can say or you can talk about that prolonged communication, yani they are talking about good communication. If you are having a good communication, that means parents are having a good communication with their children, then this will act as one of the very important factor for achievement motivation. Then other than communication, what helps is a good counseling. Then if they guide by being a role model themselves, so that also would act as a very good part. So guiding by being a good role model, guiding through examples. By being a role model. Fine. Okay. And other than that, you can also talk about their involvement. This was with respect to the family aspect. Now, when I have to talk about the cultural aspect, you can talk about a factor of unity, or you can talk about a factor of social bonds so as to do something good for the society. Social bond, unity. Here you can also talk about respect for the other culture. You can also write about how coming from that religion or coming from that culture, how your culture promotes the source of or becomes the source of achievement motivation. So that helps you in doing better. Yeah. So that could be anything. For example, the expectations, the norms. Etc. Fine. Now let's move on to the next one. The next one says, discuss the psychological and social effects of pornography addiction. Now, here, what are the psychological and social effects of pornographic addiction? So, psychologically, you can talk about, see, all anxiety, depression, you can say it comes from here. You can also say that now youth has been started, not even youth, but also the teenagers have started escaping. So they have started escaping the situations. Other than that, you can also say that somewhere or other there is desensitization for the other gender. Desensitization, etc. So this could be written in your psychological aspect. And when it comes to social effect, what you can talk about is, you can bring the aspect of social disharmony. You can also write about legal issues. You can also write about decrease, or you can say there is very imbalance. With respect to the, or respect for the other gender. So all this could be written in this question. Disharmony, legal issues, respect to imbalance with respect for the other gender. Then families can also be written over here. Having unhealthy ties or bonds with family. Fine? Okay. Discuss the strategies for promoting positive mental health among defense personnel. See, it is very important because they are talking about defense personnel. Your entire country will be under threat. So the strategies of promoting positive mental health among the defense personnel. So how could this be achieved? See, firstly, there should be screening programs. And what are those screening programs? These are mental health screening programs. Mental health screening programs. You can also talk about peer support system. You can also talk about counseling sessions. You can also talk about mental health. So other than counseling session, you can also talk about family and the respective personnel, the entire family going through the emotional support therapies. So that could be your cognitive or you can say the behavioral therapies. That means emotive behavioral therapy. Yes. This could be written. Other than that, mental health checkup, then resilience building, then so as to bring the mental strength to increase the mental strength, resilience building, mental strength, peer support, family. You can also talk about what difference personal. Yes. So you can write about community building. You can write about mindfulness. You can write about community building. So mindfulness, community building, resilience building. Yes. Many more factors are there. For example, stress reduction theory, stress management theory, because very important for them to manage their stress, because if they are stressful, then ultimately our borders are at issues. So stress management, you can talk about apart from all this. Yes. Fine. And if there is a constant participation in social activities, that would also help out. So you can write about constant social participation. Now, what is pro-environmental behavior? This design and intervention plan for developing pro-environmental behavior among school children. That means, what is pro-environmental behavior? Here you have to write about the pro-environmental behavior. So what is a pro-environmental behavior? That is talking about a behavior which is offering or is more inclined towards protection and conservation of environment. And they talk about an intervention plan for developing pro-environmental behavior among school children. That means how to design an intervention plan for developing this kind of behavior. So you can talk about what? This kind of thing is only possible if there is a lot of interactive learning. Why? Because the more they interact with the environment, the more they are able to perceive the environment through their own senses. That will help out in increasing the participation and getting, your behavior getting pro-environmental. So here you can talk about what interactive learning. Engagement in outdoor activities with respect to the environment. So interactive learning, outdoor activities, then you can talk about environmental clubs. You can talk about parents' involvement. So environmental club, parents' involvement, community participation. So all this could be written over here so as to increase the pro-environmental behavior among children. The next one is, to what extent individuals' life experiences are relevant for understanding terrorism? That means first you need to talk about what terrorism is and how is individuals' life experience help or are relevant for understanding terrorism. So you can begin here with see what happens is when the person has experienced it, so they would know more about the propagandas. So you can say that extremists propaganda gets revealed. You can also talk about they get more susceptible. You can say they have this feeling of nation built. Other than that, you can write about traumas and psychological vulnerability. See, all these trauma and psychological vulnerability is coming from where? Once the person has, have this life experience. So what happens is that they get through this trauma and they, realize how inconvenient this act of terrorism becomes. So trauma and psychological disorder that happens. Fine. Okay, so this is about your life experiences for understanding terrorism. Next is discuss the psychological consequences of population explosion. So what is population explosion? This is talking about rapid increase in population. So psychological consequences suggest some technique to enhance awareness among people for population control. So first you need to study about the consequence that is going to come. So what is the psychological consequence? Now here you can write about all the consequences. For example, you can talk about the quality of life. Quality of life, then you can also talk about vulnerability of the earth to able to meet the needs of so many people or so much of if there's a population explosion. So vulnerability of the planet, you can write about quality of life, reduce quality, vulnerability of the planet. You can also write about environmental issues. Fine. So here these are consequences. Now the point is to enhance awareness. How this awareness will happen? So here you can talk about the behavior, that means behavioral change that will help in population control. You can also talk about population control, behavioral change. You can talk about education and awareness programs. Other than that, you can also talk about family counseling. Then you can mention about the government schemes also, because that are working for the same cause. So all this will help you in dealing with the, or all these other techniques that will help in generating awareness regarding population control. Now, how does gender socialization in India leads to gender discrimination? So gender socialization leads to gender discrimination. So first you need to know about gender discrimination, then you need to know about gender socialization. So how is this happening? Now see, gender socialization is basically happening by through traditional and cultural practices. That means the traditional, the cultural practices that have been coming from so long, or they have been followed for so long. Here it could be the bio grammar. So when I talk about the bio grammar, it also talks about the traditional roles of the gender, so traditional and cultural roles based on gender. So traditional and cultural roles based on gender, then you can also talk about since the sensitization process is weak, what happens is one gender becomes very powerful. So how does gender socialization now see? Gender socialization leads to gender discrimination. Now, in some cases, what happens is that this phenomenon of who's the bread earner, who should be the bread maker, or who should be the rear end and the caretaker of the family, etc. All these roles are traditionally being defined. So that is what is leading to gender discrimination. So apart from this, you can also talk about media and stereotypes. Because in media and stereotypes, but then this is acting both way. Somewhere they are projecting one gender has to be very fragile and they have to be very feminine. But other way, they are also representing what kind of hard work they are performing. For example, the permanent commission that was granted to Indian army women. So media and stereotypes are also acting as one of the important part for this. Then you can also write about what sexual harassment you can write about violence sexual harassment and violence you can write about media and stereotypes, you can write about biogrammar, you can write about traditional and cultural roles, you can write about lack of empowerment. So lack of empowerment, you can also talk about peer pressure. There is a peer pressure from the society itself. So peer pressure. Now all this is operating towards what? Gender discrimination. They are also influencing it another way, but since the question asked you to write about gender discrimination, so you will go with this one. Now this is how you are going to formulate your points. I have discussed very little of the psychologist. That could be done when you are writing the answers, but how you are going to frame the answer, that was my point. So that is how I'll be writing it. Probably I think this could be helpful for you for your preparation. Okay, so thank you so much.